After test assembling the shed in the garage, I realized it would be nice if it was a little bit deeper. So I made the side walls a little bit longer, made longer floor joists, and I had to make longer purlins. I was able to use half the old purlins for making legs for sawhorses, so it wasn't a complete loss.
Then working out exactly where the shed is going to go, and thus being rather opportunistic about what to support the shed with.
This is where the shed is going to go, and I've leveled it out already, but it's going to go about 1.5 inches higher, so I can have some 2x6s going across where I've got the pads and the birdbath pedestal and the stump that it's going to be supported on. Now I just have to screw all of these bits to the bottom. I put the corner gussets on the wrong corners initially, but fixed now. Now ready to place it again. Now that tree stump is quite a bit too high and it's not level, so I gotta fix that. Got my shed base fixed to the supports. On this side, the birdbath pedestal, I've got some pieces here to capture the top of it so it doesn't slide out. On this side, I'm using this stump and this stump here, but it's actually not screwed into those yet, so I can still lift it a bit just in case I need to level it while I'm building it. But you can't count on a stump like that to last forever, so I've also got another support down here, not exactly on the corner, but given the slope it's kind of hard to place these things. But overall, this feels surprisingly stable, much more so than just placing it on patio stones.
These little strips of wood are for holding rigid styrofoam insulation in the floor. I'm adding a bead of caulking around the edges to help hold the styrofoam in place and also to prevent mice from nesting in there. Thank you.
This shed is going to get covered in sheet metal all around, but with just a roof on, it already turns it into a rigid box. And to demonstrate, I'll just jack up this one corner and you can see the whole shed lift. It rocks like a chair on an uneven floor. And that way I'm less concerned about my questionable supports here, because if one of those goes, it might end up leaning a bit, but it won't go at a square, and I can always jack it up to be level again. And I'm adding a layer of insulation behind the sheet metal. That way I think this will be more fun as a place for the kids to play in the winter, especially once I add windows. But there's lots of work left to be done on the shed, so I'll cover that in future videos.